Wherever Claude Lemieux has played, he has always been known as a pest. He had been successful in both Montreal and New Jersey, winning Stanley Cups in both cities. That's why the Colorado Avalanche went out and got him.
No problem on the angle for Patrick Waugh. A little pushing and shoving behind the net. Oh! Claude Lemieux drew a right hand. That was from right field. And he is going to go pushing and shoving. And Lemieux said he's had enough. And he threw that right hand. Atlantis.
And now you're going to see one of the all-time from behind sucker punches on Kozlov 13. He took a shot right there. If you're going to get into one of these, get your back to the glass.
Back the other way to Draper, waiting for his teammates to clear. Draper's hurt. He got leveled by Claude Lemieux, and he is down on the ice. This may be a huge break for the Red Wings and a real bad turn of events for the Avalanche. Well, hit from behind with his face next to the boards. He hit the dasher, the top of the boards with his cheek or his mouth or something.
Draper's cut and hurt, and Lemieux, five, and a game, and he's gone.
Lemieux will be out there in this first line for the Avalanche. It'll be Yzerman working with Darren McCarty and Kozlov on the wings with him. There they are already talking. Lemieux and McCarty, who've had a good knockdown, drag out, and there they go, right on the whistle.
Oh, baby.
They were talking to one another, and immediately at the drop of the puck, decided to go at it and get this over with.
And guess what? Claude Lemieux is not turtling on this one. Remember, it was Darren McCarty that whooped up on Lemieux last season, and Lemieux just took it, and he stayed down in a turtle. Well, maybe he's not taking it now. This is a heck of a goal right here.
This is a statement by Claude Lemieux to the Detroit Red Wings and Darren McCarty. He obviously was embarrassed that he turtled in that fight when they went against one another and had made up his mind tonight he would put an end to the turtle.